As a paleoanthropologist, Genevieve von Petzinger studies the origins and development of early humans. And today, she's exploring the ancient rock art of the indigenous Coso people.
So we got an asterisk right here, and then right here, so here's the horns, and there's its front legs and its back legs, so it's facing that way.
Genevieve is in the Coso range of California's Mohave Desert, an area inhabited by the Coso people at least 12,000 years ago.
So at the moment, I am standing in a place called Fossil Falls. This used to be a waterfall. The Coso people lived right in this vicinity, and so you could think of this sort of dried out waterfall as being their backyard. And just like we do today, they decorated their backyard.
Genevieve is searching for ancient petroglyphs, prehistoric rock art that can date back thousands of years. And hidden within these volcanic caves, there's plenty to discover.
This is basically like a big tube that goes from surface level down into the fall. We've only been here for about 15 minutes so far, and just in this one little area, we've already found some new engravings, which is really exciting. We've not only found this serpentiform outside, but we've also found a little asterisk, so like a little star back there in the corner, this wonderful bighorn sheep. And these sheep are a really popular, really important motif that we find here with the Coso. And then here, so there's a spiral. So you can see there's something sort of spirally shape. They've taken a stone tool and they basically kind of run it along the rock, and it takes that dark rock and then it shows the white stone underneath. And so now these are thousands of years old and they're kind of fading a bit, but when they were first made, it must have been really dramatic. It would have been the white popping out of the dark rock.
And it's not just the symbols that Genevieve's interested in. The acoustics in the cave might have some meaning as well.
We were noticing that there's some marks almost where it looks like they took their stone and stabbed it into the rock, and probably because there's some really interesting acoustic properties. So the way it sounds in here when I'm talking, there's a really interesting echo going on. So it's interesting to wonder if it wasn't just about the pictures, but maybe also about the sound at the same time.
Carved and painted rock art can be found throughout the world, telling stories from an ancient past.
If you think about it, these are like the great-great-great-great-great-grandparents of emojis. Simple little characters with huge amounts of information embedded into them. But you need to be part of the culture group to be able to decipher it. You have to know the code.
But even without fully understanding what the symbols mean, Genevieve can still find some clues based on history.
We've come just a little bit further up the river now, and we're looking at this other little enclosed space where there is this thing here called an Atlatl. And so an Atlatl is basically a spear thrower. And apparently here, they used it all the way from, you know, 13,000 up till about 2,000 years ago. So my understanding is that this must be at least 2,000 years old, and it could very well be older.
And considering about half the Coso carvings depict bighorn sheep, we can wonder whether an atlatl was used to hunt them. And there's always more to explore.
They're finding new caves all the time. There's some I know but I'm not allowed to talk about yet. There are so many caves out there just waiting to be discovered. There are so many engravings waiting to be discovered. And this is all over the world.